Welcome back to The Breakfast here on PLOS TV Africa. And now time for Today in History. I'm going back to the year 2015, to the day that the 8th National Assembly was inaugurated. It, you know, did happen with some controversy that, of course, made a lot of headlines across the country then. But the 8th National Assembly of the Federal Republic of Nigeria was a bicameral legislature inaugurated on the 9th of June in 2015, and it's ran its course until June 9th in 2019. The elections were conducted at the National Assembly Complex in Abuja, of course, the Federal Capital Territory, and the assembly was inaugurated on this day at around 10 a.m. following the reading of the proclamation letter of President Muhammadu Buhari, who, of course, ordered the inauguration of the assembly. Out of 59 senators elect, only 57 were in attendance, in line with the Senate rule that stipulated that only 2/3 of the total senators needed to be present to form a quorum. Senator Bukola Saraki was nominated as candidate for the office of the Senate President and eventually did, you know, take that position. His nomination, of course, was given by Senator Sani Yerima and Senator Dino Melaye, representing Kogi West. The election of the leadership of the House of Representatives was also conducted by the clerk. National Assembly comprises 469 members, of course, across Nigeria's six geopolitical zones. So it was on this day that, you know, that 8th National Assembly was inaugurated. The controversial part of all of this was so how did this play out? So, I mean, there was word that the elections weren't carried out by the full members of National Assembly, that there were, you know, there was a meeting, that or notice of a meeting to be held in some place in Abuja, and some senators, of course, went for that meeting. But unknown to them, there was nominations going on, elections going on in National Assembly. So by the time they were able to rush all the way back, drive through Abuja traffic, the elections had been done. And Bukola Saraki had been nominated as president of the Senate at that time. So it was pretty interesting. But of course, a lot of people have also said that the 8th National Assembly has been also one of the most interesting ones because of their stance. It was a PDP head of the the National Assembly a country where the APC was, you know, in power, and so it seemed like the National Assembly was fully expressing itself as an opposition, or to counter or to checkmate the excessiveness of the executive at that time. And so that's one of the things that they were known for. Eventually, when Bukola Saraki was leaving the National Assembly, along with a couple of other people, Shehu Sani, Dino Melaye, and others, there's also those who said, the 9th National Assembly will be for Nigeria and, you know, working hand in hand with the current administration, and will be able to do better than the 8th National Assembly. I don't know if, you know, we would agree that they have done better than the 8th National Assembly. Anyway.
Indeed, interesting story there about that particular day. And another interesting day in history, it was 1977. On this day in history, we had the Silver Jubilee of the Queen Elizabeth II in the United Kingdom. This day was celebrated actually throughout the whole year. You know, so millions of people actually gathered on this day, June the 9th, to celebrate, to throw parties, you know, have bonfires, fireworks, just celebrate the Silver Jubilee of Queen Elizabeth II, which marked her 25th anniversary of her accession to the thrones of the United Kingdom and other Commonwealth realms. So all the celebrations culminated in June with the official Jubilee Days, which held to coincide with the Queen's birthday. And she made a royal progress trip, that was on the 9th of June, this day in history, via boats up the River Thames from Greenwich to Lambeth. And this all reenacted the famous progresses taken by Queen Elizabeth I. On this very trip, she also officially opened, you know, several places in the UK were named after these Jubilee Days, and they include the Silver Jubilee Walkway, the South Bank Jubilee Gardens, and it was just a great period of celebration. You could just remember people saying, "Oh, I was 10 years old, you know, during this day.
Yeah.
I won a ticket to go watch the Queen during the festivities." People saying, "Oh, I wonder if all these carriages are all, you know, they're gold plated to say, I wonder if they're real gold." People just relive the experience of that day, June 7th, 1977, about when the Queen, you know, celebrated her silver jubilee. And today, you know, we know that last week, the Royal Palace started to reel out plans for her, her celebration for this year. It's to be her platinum jubilee. So Queen Elizabeth II would be the longest serving monarch in Britain's history. The platinum jubilee will be celebrated with royal festivities, royal engagement that will be celebrated throughout this year. So it's a beautiful lineup of events. They would extend the bank holiday to the weekend. You know, it's just amazing. A music concert will take place in Buckingham Palace. And this is after, you know, many, many celebrations were scaled down because of the COVID-19 pandemic and all the lockdowns. You know, so it's just a beautiful day of celebration.
What day is that going to be?
June 9th, today.
Oh, okay. No, I mean, the next celebrations, the one you're talking about?
The Platinum Jubilee.
Yeah.
It started last week on the 2nd.
Okay.
You know,
so it's not too late for me to go cover it for Plus TV Africa.
You're a Benin man. You can carry your broom. You can just
wow.
be there right after
Plus
9
TV,
a.m.
So can't I be you guys' correspondent over there for the next couple of days?
So sadly, she became a widow when her husband, Prince Philip, died at the age of 99.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
All right. Must be nice being a queen, you know, and having absolutely no job, you know, but just be a queen
what?
And just live
that's,
your life.
That's a job.
That's not a job.
That's a job. She dedicated really her life to service, basically. That's a full job. Don't you dare say that.
All right.
You're not wearing the shoe, so you don't know where it hurts.
Yeah, right.
Simply because you have money doesn't mean you have no problems, does it?
Oh, yeah, right.
Don't listen to us again.
Okay, good
that's
morning.
That's it, yeah.
That's what we have for you today in history, 1977 and the year 2015. Short break. We're going to take a break. Now, when we come back, we're moving into our first conversation, and that is with regards, once again, the Twitter ban. The House of Representatives has summoned the Minister of Information, Nai Mohammed, and of course, a little bit of drama that occurred yesterday. We'll get into it with our guest this morning. Stay with us. We'll be back.